आचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तिदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तदुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपेव अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमोऽस्तु मे निश्चितामतिः। थ्री फिफ्टी नाइन्थ आवर्त स्टिल विथ नैयायिक पक्ष। आत्मा व्यापक अनेक कर्ता भोक्ता च इति न्यायमतस्य निराकरणम्। रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ द मत व्यू पॉइंट ऑफ द न्याय दर्शन वेर दे से आत्मा इज व्यापक बट स्टिल अनेक एंड व्यापकत्व वी सॉ एज सकल अल्प पदार्थी ही सह संयोग व्यापकत्वम्। सो हियर व्यापक एंड अनेक इज पॉसिबल इन नैयायिक पक्ष। इन अवर पक्ष वी के नॉट यूज व्यापक एंड से अनेक बिकॉज व्यापकत्वम हैज टू नेसेसरली मीन एक बिकॉज व्यापकत्व डेफिनेशन इज सजातीय विजातीय स्वगत भेद शून्यत्वम्। देन कर्ता एंड भोक्ता इन द सांख्य पक्ष वी सॉ द आत्मा इज भोक्ता। इन वन सांख्य मत देयर आत्मा इज भोक्ता बट नॉट कर्ता। पुरुष दिस इज पुरुष इज भोक्ता नॉट कर्ता वेर एज नैयायिका से आत्मा इज कर्ता भोक्ता। एंड यू हैव सीन ऑल दिस ज्ञान ज्ञानादि सुख दुखादि दीज आर दी गुणा विच आर रेस्टिंग इन आत्मा दे आर उत्पन्न इन आत्मा बाय सम संयोग। अदरवाइज आत्मा इज स्वरूपतः जड़ा। सकल आत्मनाम सकल पदार्थैः सह संयोगः अस्ति इति न्यायमतम्। दैट इज व्यापकत्वम्। सकल आत्मनाम ऑल द आत्मास विच आर व्यापक दे हैव संयोग विद सकल पदार्थ विच आर अल्प ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज द आत्मा इज व्यापक इन कंपैरिजन ऑल ऑफ द पदार्थ वुड बी अल्प अदर पदार्थ। नाना आत्मनाम व्यापकैः परिच्छिन्नैः सकलैरपि देहेन्द्रिय मनोभिः परमाणुभिश्च संयोग अस्ति इति नैयायिकमतं न संगच्छते। दैट काइंड ऑफ अ मत व्यू पॉइंट वेर इन नाना आत्मास हैव संयोग संबंध विथ अव्यापक परिच्छिन्न सकल पदार्थास सच एज व्हाट देह इंद्रिय मनस एंड द अनात्म पदार्थ सच एज परमाणुस ऑल क्रिएटेड बाय परमाणुस द एंटायर जगत। देहेन्द्रिय मनस ऑल्सो इज पार्ट ऑफ जगत बट देन वी सी देम एज डिफरेंटली। समहाउ वी सी देहेन्द्रिय मनस एज सेंशियंट एटलीस्ट द बीइंग हु हैज दैट देहेन्द्रिय मनस संयोग दैट एंटिटी इज सेंशियंट। सो देर इज संबंध विथ देहेन्द्रिय एंड मनस आत्मसंबंध इज देयर। नॉट वन आत्मसंबंध ऑल आत्मास हैव संबंध विथ ऑल देहेन्द्रिय एंड मनस एंड दे हैव संबंध विथ ऑल परमाणुज ऑल्सो ऑल आत्मास। नाउ इंटरेस्टिंगली देवदत्ताज आत्मा राहु शिरोवत षष्टी देयर देवदत्ताज आत्मा हैज संयोग विथ नॉट ओनली देवदत्त इंद्रिय देहेन्द्रिय मनस बट ऑल्सो यज्ञदत्ताज देहेन्द्रिय मनस चैत्र मैत्रास देहेन्द्रिय मनस एंड एवरी वन देहेन्द्रिय एंड मनस। Similarly, each of the other entities also Atmatvena, Vyapakatvena, they have Sanyoga with everybody's Dehendriya Manas. This is what will be the resultant of this analysis, of this Nayayika Mata. Nayayika Matam, Ichi Yat Matam, Tanna Sangachate. That is not valid. How so? Tathahi Vyapakanam Nanatmanam Angikare Sarva Sharirehi Sarvesham Vyatmanam Sanyoga Angikaryaha. You will have to necessarily accept the Sanyoga of all Atmas with all Dehendriyas and Manas. Tadacha Idam Shariram Asya Eva Atmanaha Na Itarasya Atmanaha Iti Nishchayaka Pramana Bhavat Ekaikasya Atmana Sarvani Api Sharirani Sambandini Iti Apatet. So the resultant is that each Atma, all the Atmas are Vyapaka, all the Shariras are Alpas. Shariras in the sense, all the Shariras. Stula Sukshma Karana Sharira also, but here we are looking at Deha, Indriya and Manas at least. So every Atma will have Sambandha with every Deha, Indriya, Manas, every Stula Sukshma Sharira at least, and then you won't be able to say this Sharira belongs to Devadatta's Atma. Devadatta Sharira belongs to Devadatta's Atma. Yajnaratta Sharira belongs to Shariratraya, belongs to Yajnaratta's Atma. How will you differentiate? Tadacha idam shariram asyeva atmanaha na itarasya atmanaha iti nishchayaka pramana bhavat. There is no pramana to differentiate and assert that this sharira is belonging to this atma, the other sharira belongs to other atma. What is the nishchayaka pramana there? With on what basis will you definitely say that this sharira belongs to this atma? There is a mix-up of jivas now. All the karma yavastha has gone for a toss. Yasya karmana yat shariram arabdham tadeva shariram tadatma sambandhi iti vyavastha apina yujyet. There is no possibility of saying that this sharira began with this jivatma's karma prarabdha, therefore this sharira belongs to this particular jiva alone. There is no vyavastha at all. Yato yena sharirena yat karma kritam tena api sharirena sakalatmanam sambandho abhut tasmat karma api sakalatma sambandhyeva bhavet. Karma vyavastha is not valid. How will phala vyavastha be valid? Phala should be given to a particular karma through a particular sharira. Now every atma is connected to every sharira, which is utpanna by due to different karmas by different jivas, but every jiva has to have upabhoga of every karma done by every other jiva also, because of having no differentiation between shariras, as this sharira is mine. Natu ekatmatra sambandhi bhavet. So karma is also related to all atmas, not particular atmas. Who have taken a particular sharira in the earlier janmas and have done particular karmas, only those karma phalas should be endured or enjoyed, as the case may be, by that particular jiva alone, not by other. That karma yavastha is also invalidated. Sorry. Yasya atmana manas sahitam yat shariram abhu tasya atmanaha tadeva shariram ityuktirapi na samichina. Even the vyavastha at the time of association with a particular manaha, that also is invalidated. the sukshma sharira and sthula sharira sambandha also will be invalidated. You can't have a vyavastha. You can't have vyavastha saying that this manas is associated to this sthula sharira which belongs to this atma. So tippana here. So nischaya vachakena eva karana that we saw yesterday, I think. Pratishidhyate. Here particular what we saw as ekameva dvitiya, that is described here. So anyway, let's go through this. This was in continuation with what was explained in the earlier tippana, but some number issue is there, that's why I didn't go ahead. Here you see one and then this two is bracketed. Here there is a somehow there is a two again. So anyway, let's just for completion sake I'll go through this. Nischaya vachakena eva karena, in the mantra ekam eva dvitiyam, we had seen this in the last part. Nischaya vachakena eva karena atmanah nirapeksha vyapakatvam bodhyate. This vyapakatattva of atma is one without a second, that is asserted by evakara. Definitely ekaha, ekam meva, definitely one, only one. Tena cha kala kritaha antaha pratishidyate. So kala paricheda is denied by that. Advitiya padena bheda pratiyogyanvaya, bheda pratiyogi anyavastu nishedatmani, nishedat, sorry. So just let me confirm that, where is the one? I am unable to see. Maybe this is the one. So ekapadena sajatiya bhedaha nishidyate eva karna vijatiya bheda nishedo bhavati and advitiya padena swagata bheda nishedascha bhavati. This is what we had seen last, and then I think this should be one below this topic. So it is an explanation. Tathahi ekapadena. So if you take this as one, this is A, or you know, subtitle one here, subtopic one. So ekapadena deshakrita anta nishiddha. Then evakarena kalakrita anta pratishidhyate. Then advitiya padena bheda pratiyogi anya vastu nishedhat. So there is a typo here. Nishedhat atmani vastukrataha api antah pratishiddaha. So desha paricheda by desha paricheda is denied by, is negated by ekam in the mantra ekameva dvitiyam. Eva karana, with the eva kara pada, eva pada, the kala krita paricheda is denied, and then advitiya padena ekameva dvitiyam. So advitiya pada with that word vastukrita paricheda is denied. Itham siddhanta uktam ubhaya vidham api vyapakatva lakshanam shrutyanusari. So the definition of vyapakatva as used by siddhanti is valid. However, it is defined vyapakatva nirvachanam shrutyayo pradarshitam. And Shruti shows that vyapakatva definition. We have derived that definition only by looking at the mantras of the Shruti, not Sakopolo Kalpita as Nayayikas have. Yatra nanyat pashyati, nanyat chrunoti, nanyat vijanati sa bhuma iti. Vastukrita paricheda bhava siddhya eva. Deshakalakrita paricheda bhava api arthat siddha deshakalayur api vastvantargatatvat. So vasati iti vastu, even if you take vyavaharika reality, you say some vastu is there. When you say vastu is there, it means it is something is, asti, astitvat vastu. And that astitva may not be real, it is figurative usage also. If you can use the tinganta padam asti, then that particular thing you talk about can be called as a vastu. Now, the Shruti says, yatra nanyat pashyati, nanyat shrunoti, nanyat vijanati sa bhuma. That purna vastu is the real vastu, where there is nothing else. and that is the lakshan of vyapakatva. You cannot have another vyapakatva. That is how our definition is in keeping with Shruti, whereas Nayayika's definition is not valid at all. Now the ekam eva dvitiyam, in that mantra ekam has been mentioned, by ekam vastu krita paricheda is denied. Then why do you need evakara and advitiya pada for kala paricheda and for desha? So here you see, so ekam, we have explained ekam here as what? As negating desha krita paricheda and evakara as negating the kala krita paricheda. Advitiya pada is denying the vastukrita paricheda. Now Tippanakara says that one is sufficient. In fact, this advitiya pada itself is sufficient. That's why we say advaita, or Vedanta is called as advaita Vedanta. We don't need to talk about desha and kala not being there in Brahman, in our understanding of atma. Why? Because vastukrita paricheda, with the vastukrita paricheda abhavad, vastukrita parichedasya abhavadeva, by the siddhi of vastukrita parichedasya abhava, by showing that there is no differentiation or segmentation in vastu, by that itself deshakalakrita paricheda abhavaha api arthat siddha. You attain the siddhi of showing that there is no other desha, no other kala also. Why? Because desha astiva nastiva, kalaha astiva nastiva. If you ask, then our usage is desha asti, kalaha asti. Thereby desha and kala become vastu. Yogika prayoga. By derivation, you see that desha and kala vasati iti vastu. Then if you have denied the vastukrita parichida, then desha kala are also vastus. They are also shown to be not there, as different from atma. So advitiya pada is sufficient. That is what is being mentioned here. Okay, going back to mula. Yasya atmana manas sahitam yat shariram abhut, tasya atmana tadeva shariram iti uktirapi na samichina. Sharirena eva manasa api sakalatmanam api sambandhasya sadharanyat idam manaha asyeva atmanaha iti nischaye api pramanam nasti. So details are being seen of the general refutation statements. Since there is no, you see, sharirena eva manasa api sakalatmanam api sambandhasya sadharanyat. Since there is a sadharana sambandha with all shariras of all atmas, similarly there is a sambandha with manas, all minds of all atmas. Sakalatmanam api sambandhasya manasa api sharirena iva manasa api sakalatmanam api sambandhasya sadharanyat. You cannot differentiate as to, the way you cannot differentiate this sharira belongs to this atma, similarly you cannot differentiate this manas belongs to this atma. Manaha asya eva atmanaha iti nischaye api. Even if you say that I want to say that this manas belongs to this atma, there is no pramana. Iti nischaye api pramanam nasti. There is no pramana at all by which you can associate one manas with one atma. Kintu sakalatmanam sakalanyapi manamsi sambandhini eva bhavanti tathaiva indriyanyapi sakalatma sambandhini eva bhavanti. So we know now what has been said earlier. Indriya, deha, indriya and manas cannot be separated out per atma. All atmas will have all deha, indriya and manas. Bahya padarteshu ayam padarthaha madiyaha ayam anyadiha iti vyavahara sharira nimittakaha. only by associating with the sharira and the set of indriyas with the mind backing can you say that this padartha is mine, this vishaya which is outside the sharira, that vishaya is mine, this is yours. You know, this is my pen, this is my laptop, this is my whatever, you know. When children are playing, you know, even with the parents, you know, they even when they are playing, they say, oh, you see another kid with your mother, you say, this is my mother. So the kids have this, you know, they're attached, they say, she is my mother, she's not your mother, she's my mother. So why is that claim there? Because of sharira sambandha. The kid also knows that this is my mother due to sharira sambandha. That sharira is born of that mother. All other padarthas also, the kid will be saying that this is my toy, it is not yours. A generous kid will say, okay, you play with it, but then you see that he has given his toy to the others. That shashti sambandha is possible with the sharira drishti. So bahya padartheshu ayam padartho madiyaha ayam anyadiha iti vyavahara sharira nimittakaha sharira shariram nimittam yasya yasya vyavaharasya saha vyavahara sharira nimittakaha yakkaschid vyavaharaha. So any vyavahara you take, that vyavahara is with the basis that this sharira belongs to me. This is my sharira, or I am this person, this entity, and then only the outward padartha sambandha is possible. Now when the sharira sambandha itself is not having any nishchaya, whether I am associated with this sharira or that sharira, then how will you have padartha sambandha also? प्रदर्शित रीत्या सर्वशरीराणां सर्वात्म साधारण्यात् सर्वेपि बाह्या सर्वात्म संबंधिन एव भवन्ति. Therefore the entire prapancha sambandha is also there for all atmas. So you look at this sarvatma bhava that Shruti talks about, Nayayika has erroneously landed on it. Not really landed, all theory. There is no understanding at all. This sarvatma bhava of multiple atmas associated with the entire prapancha in multiple ways. So even in sarvatma bhava there is plurality. That kind of a ridiculous thing they have landed on. Atha yadi nayayiko bruyat. But now the nayayika responds. On your understanding, the Vedantin's understanding of nayapaksha, he clarifies. यस्य आत्मनः यस्मिन् शरीरे अहम् मम बुद्धिः भवतः तस्य आत्मनः तदेव शरीरम्. He says, but there is a difference. Just like you explained, the child says my mother because he knows this is my sharira. Although he has sambandha with all shariras, even the child has aham and mama buddhi with his own sharira, not other sharira. Wherever he has that sambandha, that is his sharira. The other is not his sharira. It is as simple as that. Aham iti buddhir eka eva, tatha mama iti buddhir api eka eva. Very simple, he says. I have a very simple resolution. Wherever there is aham buddhi, that is his sharira. And wherever he has mama buddhi, that is his padartha. Tasmat sarveshu atmasu sa buddhir na bhavet. Although all atmas have sambandha with all shariras, Ahamkara and Mamakara isn't there. Therefore, wherever there is Ahamkara, Mamakara, that is his Sharira, that is his Padartha. Why do you complicate it? Why do you erroneously explain our Siddhanta? Says the Nayayika. He says it is as simple. Do you have Ahamkara in all Shariras? You don't have. So that Buddhi is Eka, Aham Buddhi is Eka. Thereby, wherever you have aham buddhi, that is your sharira. Tasmat sarveshu atmasu sa buddhir na bhavet. And that aham buddhi is not there. In your sharira, you alone have aham buddhi. Others do not have aham buddhi. किंतु एकः धर्मः एकधर्मी आश्रितः एव भवेत्। He says you don't understand this dharma-dharmi sambandha. There is a samavaya sambandha, dharma and dharmi. It's a nitya sambandha. And that is there in one dharmi, there is this dharma sambandha. So dharma asya asti iti dharmi. He has this ahanta dharma. Aham bhava is there in one sharira. So this person, this atma becomes shariri. He becomes idam shariri. He only this sharira, not other sharira. Others also, atmas do not have that dharma. Therefore, they are not idam sharira dharmi. They are having tat sharira dharma. So tat sharira dharmi. There's a difference. Ahankara and mamakara is make or break in our darshana. Tasmad ekasya eva atmanah sambandhi bhavati. तथा च यस्य आत्मनः यच्छरीरं संबंधी भवति तेन शरीरेण संबंधानि तेन शरीरेण संबद्धानि मन इंद्रिय बाह्य वस्तुनि तदात्म संबंधीनि एव तस्माद् व्यापक नानात्मनाम् अंगीकारेऽपि न दोषः इति। सो ही सेज़ वी कैन हैव नाना व्यापक आत्मास, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम देयर बिकॉज़ अहंकारा ममकारा इज नॉट देयर विथ ऑल शरीरास। सापि वार्ता असंगतैव। सो द सिद्धांती अद्वैतिन सेज दैट इज आल्सो नॉट वैलिड। अहम इति बुद्धिर एकस्मिन् शरीरे एकस्यैव आत्मना भवति इत्येतत् न्यायमतेन युज्यते। दिस स्टेटमेंट सेइंग दैट दिस अहम बुद्धि इज इन वन शरीर that is not valid. Kintu sarvesham api atmanam ekasmin sharire aham iti buddhir bhavitum arhati. What is the basis why aham buddhi is there in only in one sharira? If the sanyoga is with all shariras, aham buddhi cannot be only in one sharira. What is the reason? Tatahi nyayamate buddhir nama jnanam. Now what is this buddhi? It is jnana. Aham buddhi that you have here, that is also jnana. Tachya jnanam atma manaso sanyogena utpadyate. He says, now you go back and look into your darshana. Aham buddhi, now you are saying aham buddhi, wherever you have aham buddhi, that is your sharira, not the other. Whichever atma has aham buddhi with whichever sharira, that atma has that sharira, not other atmas. Other atmas do not have that sharira. So both ways we explained from the perspective of the sharira, to which atma this sharira belongs. Whoever has aham buddhi, this sharira belongs to that atma. And from atma perspective also we have explained. As to not all atmas have aham buddhi with every sharira. They have aham buddhi only with particular shariras. Therefore, all shariras, manas indriya also do not have sambandha with all atmas. There is some sanyoga sambandha, but there is no aham buddhi mama buddhi. Now you are jumping the gun. There is a catch 22 situation, says the Siddhantin. Your jnana, aham buddhi is jnana. Jnana is utpanna in atma as per your own darshana. This aham buddhi, idam shariram aham or idam shariram mama, that buddhi which comes up, that is jnana. This jnana is utpanna only when the padartha sambandha takes place. Atma and manas samyoga takes place. Now when you are saying this manas, which wherever you have this mind is mine, that mind becomes your own. Whereas that mind becoming your own is an aham buddhi, mama buddhi, which is jnana rupa, which cannot be utpanna because it is utpanna only after the sanyoga with the manas. So, saying that wherever there is aham buddhi in the atma, that manas becomes that atma's. That manas belongs to that atma and not the other manas. You have no basis because that jnana aham buddhi will be utpanna only after the manas sanyoga with the atma. Now this manasanyoga precedes the jnanotpatti. Whereas you are making a conclusion and answering my objection by showing that wherever there is this jnanotpatti, wherever there is this aham buddhi or mama buddhi unto a particular manas or sharira or indriya, that's where the sanyoga is established as having a claim over that body. That's where you have karma sambandha also, not unto other shariras, indriyas, dehas, sharira, indriyas and manas. So the catch 22, you cannot have ahankara buddhi unto a particular manas unless mana and atma sanyoga is there. And you cannot say that mana atma sanyoga is validated as this sambandha is validated only with one particular manas and one particular atma. There is only one to one sanyoga of ahankara and mamakara unless there is sanyoga. You cannot establish that at all. So the catch 22, it is failing. Tathahi nyayamate buddhir nama jnanam tachya jnanam atma manasu sanyogena utpadyate manasa sanya sanyoga sarvesham atma namasti. Now this manas and atma sanyoga is there with each and every manas and of each and every atma. So there is a many to many sanyoga in your system because manas is anuparimana and atma is vyapaka. Each manas is anuparimana. So sakala alpa padarthaihi sa. Sakala manobhi saha. Sakala alpa parimana manobhi or anuparimana manobhi saha. Sarvesham atmanam sanyoga asti eva. So there is a many to many sanyoga always there in your system. Then this jnanotpatti of ahankara and mamakara with particular manas will not be possible. It will be there in all atmas with respect to all manas. So manasa saha sanyoga sarvesham atmanam asti. Atascha manasa sanyogena yada ekasmin sharire ekasya atmana aham buddhi rudeti tada sarvesham api atmana aham buddhi rudetum arhati. Everyone should have it, not only one particular atma. It is not possible in your own analysis. We are using your own tools and in that it doesn't look possible. Atha yadyevam pratyavasthiyate. If he explains this vyavastha as what? यद्यपि मनसा सह संयोग सर्वात्म साधारण तथापि यस्मिन्नात्मनि ज्ञानजनकादृष्टम् अस्ति ज्ञानजनक अदृष्टम् अस्ति. नाउ ही सेइंग देयर अदृष्टा, दैट अदृष्टा इज आल्सो ज्ञानजनक. एज टू व्हाट? दिस इज माय शरीर, दिस इज माय मनस, दिस इज माय इंद्रिय. तस्येव आत्मनः अहं बुद्धिर् उत्पद्यते इति. So that aham buddhi with respect to a particular dehendriya manaha will be possible only for a particular atma, although there is sanyoga with all atmas. It is possible only due to adrishta. Tadapi asangatam eva. That is also not right. Why? Tathahi yaha vyapaka nana atmangi karta tasya mate eka sharirastha शुभाशुभ कर्मभ्याम तच्छरीर संबंध सर्वात्मना अपि अदृष्टोदयः अवश्यम् अंगीकर्तव्यः. दिस अदृष्टा दैट यू टॉक अबाउट, वेर इज इट? नैयायिका सेज दैट दिस अदृष्टा शुभ अशुभ कर्मभ्याम एक शरीरस्थ शुभ अशुभ कर्मभ्याम तच्छरीर संबंध सर्वात्मनाम अपि अदृष्टा उदयो अवश्यम अंगीकर्तव्यम. बिकॉज व्यापक नानात्व अंगीकर्ता यह नैयायिकः हू सेज दैट आत्मा इज व्यापक नाना तस्य मते इन इज दर्शन ओवरलैपन एक शरीरस्थ शुभ अशुभ कर्मभ्याम तच्छरीर संबंध सर्वात्मनाम अपि अदृष्टा उदयो अवश्यम अंगीकर्तव्य. दिस अदृष्टा, how is it born? Adrishta is born due to earlier karma being done by a particular set of Shariratraya. So you'll have Manasika Karma, you'll have Vachika Karma Ityadi, Kayika Karma. This is done by a particular Sharira, all right, but there all other Atmas were also having Sanyoga earlier. So how is this Adrushta born for a particular Jiva? That Vyavastha will also not be valid, because there is Sanyoga with all Shariras, all Manas, all Indriyas. Therefore, all Atmas will have done all sorts of Karmas, which are done by all Shariras, all Manas and all Indriyas. Thereby, Adrushta will be born for all Atmas. So how will you differentiate that this Adrushta is different and for a particular Jiva? Atma, you cannot differentiate that karma vyavastha itself is invalidated. Adrushta itself is not possible for a particular Atma. Therefore, if you say no, this Sharira did that, therefore for this particular Atma there should be Adrushta. No, Adrushta Udaya Sarvatmanam Api Avashyam Angikartavyaha Yam Varta Purvamevukta, that has been mentioned earlier. Tasmad Vyapaka Nana Atma Angikare Ekasmin Sharire Sarvesham Api Atmanam Sukadukha Bhogapattir Apariharya Natu Tatha Asti Anubhava. And Anubhava Virodha is being shown as having Nana Vyapaka Atmas which have Sambandha with all Alpa Padarthas. Their Sukha Utpanna in one Atma will be Utpanna in others also. Sukha Dukha Bhoga also will be there for all Atmas, not for one. Natu Tatha Asti Anubhava, that Anubhava isn't there. My Dukha is mine, nobody partakes of it. This is a complaint, you know. How can you partake of my Dukha? It is not lessening. I can't tap into your Sukha. Otherwise, I would have been happy. Can't do that. Tasmat Atma Vyapakaha Nana Karta Bhoktacha Iti Nyaya Siddhanta Na Samichinaha. Atma being Nyaya Matoktam Vyapakattva Lakshanam Shruti Yukti Lokanubhava Virudham. Shruti Virodha we have shown Ekameva Advitiyam. Yukti Virodha we have shown through and through. Then Lokanubhava also Virodha we have shown by showing that there is no Sukha Dukha Anubhava of others. Therefore, Atma is not Nana. Atma being Vyapaka and Nana is not possible. Atma cannot be Karta and Bhokta also. Sharira is the Karta Bhokta. If you show Nana Atma and Vyapaka, then each Atma you'll have as Karta and Bhokta of each and every karma done by all Shariras. Iti Nyaya Siddhanta na Samichinaha. Antakkaranam eva kartru bhokturcha. We'll look at this paksha in this point in the next part. Sukha nityam saprakasham vyapakam nama rupe adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyatva nirmalam param sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak paramah tadeva hannamatto nirdime nishchitamatihi. Om tatsat. Namaste.
Namaste.